So here's the third day, and I figured you might want to see our storage, because no reason. So this is where we store all our stuff, and I'll do a little tour. It's quite a lot, but we try to make it sorted in some way. This is the wall. As you can see, it's row one, closed one, I don't know, it's 0, 1, etc. These are all IBM PC compatible machines and Macs. It says as well on the top over here. As you can see, the top one, so basically, the top layer is only monitors, and below we just stack everything what's considered as either IBM PC compatible or Mac compatible or even Macs. We have laptops, quite a few. So that's why we don't take any more laptops, because this is literally how much we have. A few tulips, tendon. We have more tendon, head start, laser. We have a few PS2s over here. Servers, more lasers, more tulip, more Dutch computers. IBM's over there. We have some Philips computers too. Yeah, this is not a computer, but it's wrong. We still we are actually working very hard with all our volunteers to put this on our website. So we are we're putting them on the website. We have quite a lot. We try to organize it in a way we can actually find it back. Then we go to the opposite side. That's row number two. Here you'll find, besides the monitors on top, obviously, you'll find, well, pretty much unsorted stuff. There's random Amigas over there. Also a few Macintoshes. There are the Philips P2000s, Philips P2000s over there. There's an Apple II clone, Philips Yes. We have three of them, or four, I don't know, you have to count them. And over here we go to the empty cases. There's some luggable stuff over there. Bontwell, I can see Compaq. Empty cases. There's a Philips P2000C and monitors. Bunch of Macs. Bunch of Macintoshes over there. G4, G3, G4, I think they are. Again, random stuff. We have quite a lot Epson HX20s. All the same. All these boxes are Epson HX20. Here's a Tandy 2000, TRS-80 Model 4P, Model 4, Model 3s, another 4P, another 2000, just random stuff, not sorted at all. So guys, we still need to sort this out. The whole side over here are boxes, empty boxes, I have to say. These are all empty. Just some another random stuff. Empty boxes over here. It's all empty. Then we get to the slightly more sorted material. So here are a few boxes with the stuff in it. So yes, that's a VC1020 over there in a box. Here we have a box with Sinclair. just all Sinclair stuff is in here. This is a box with Amiga 1200s. And for some reason an Atari and ugly Atari and a Commodore C64. Color computers, these are all filled, these boxes. Okay, let's see. We have some weird storage over here. Two Sun Spark Classics. A box of Amiga 500s, a box of Atari 1040s. Right there, the 8-bit Ataris. We have a few color computers over there. MSX. This is the Commodore 128D, the heavy one. And right there, more MSX computers. Going to the top is the C64Cs are here with 1+4. CDTV, VIC-20. And then we get the back of an ASIC 64. Another MSX. A few Ataris. And to the bottom. There's speakers over here. There's a box of speakers. Some home-built computers. We still have to research them. What they are. What they should do. Box. With also a mobile. Here's a Corona. Corona. And that one is also a home build. Then we have a Sharp over here. Other random stuff. And then we have all these Macs. And then we have the whole indie part. Indigo 2. Indigo 2. Impact 10,000. We have these the little Atari portfolios. We have plenty of those. Commodore Webbit, an Indy 2, and there's a Power Macintosh and an IBM 5155. Some the expansion interface for the Tandy TRS-80, and some random printer which looks like it's from Tandy as well. Here we have a Sony Ericsson, or an Ericsson computer. It's an Ericsson computer, this one. And again, plenty of monitors all to go. And the opposite side of that is row 3. It's usually storage. It should be. Although there are still some random computers like a DAI over there. And a known laptop. Which is actually booked in our system already. But well, we have drives. All kinds of different drives and storage media and modems in top over here. There's all modems. More storage. And other random stuff. Speakers again. And boxes. Boxes, boxes. With the modem and multi-pack interface for Tandy. And this is still, we need to sort this out. Yeah. And then we go to the row number 5. This is actually, we have to figure out a place for those. More stuff. This is all small computer devices. As you can see, as you can see, there's the MC10 over there, but there's also Laser 310 in there. I know some stuff, and look, empty shelves. And then we go to the printer department, printers and scanners, and yeah, random stuff. Again, random stuff. We have Linksys. There's not much to see here in these two rows. We have software. All boxes with discs, several sizes, and that continues all over here. Every box you see over here is mostly software, and sometimes a box with some documentation, but it's software most of the time. And yes, this is our next thing. We have to figure out what the software is. Yes, 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 we have a lot. And then the final place where, again, software boxes. And this is all, it is actually sorted. So it's only software. It's only software. And some broken unit. You have to, hello, it's me. And a photoplay, which is empty. And where we started is actually the top part of our Sega Rally 2, which we still have to pick up, but it doesn't fit in my van. So yeah, if you after this whole COVID-19 is finally fixed, we'll have this machine and you can actually play on the real arcade machine. So yeah, that's it for today. Probably tomorrow I won't make a video because we are closed tomorrow entirely. So next video expect Wednesday. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask. If you like it, give a thumbs up. And everything else is somewhere in the description about Patreon and Facebook and all that kind of jazz. Have a good weekend and see you next week.